Happy Monday, Calvary. Pastor Chad here with your word for the day, looking at Mark chapter 10. Before we get to the text, can I just remind you that there's a couple of really important things coming up. First of all, tomorrow is election day and would love for you to vote. God has blessed us, allowing us to live in a nation where we have freedom and we get to participate in the system. So if you're a citizen, then please get to the polls and cast your vote tomorrow if you haven't already done that. The other thing that I'd remind you about is this Saturday, November 7th, is Serve Our Schools. We're going to be blessing our community by improving our schools, public, charter, and private. So if you're free Saturday morning, then sign up on our website, come join us, and help serve our schools. So Mark chapter 10, verse 1, very short passage. Let me just read this to you and let's talk about it. It says, "And Jesus left there and went to the region of Judea and beyond the Jordan, and crowds gathered to him again. And again, as was his custom, Jesus taught them." Crowds followed Jesus. Wherever Jesus went, he drew crowds of people around him. And normally, we all kind of like crowds to a greater or lesser degree, but right now we're living in a moment of history where people are kind of anti-crowd. I mean, just a few short months ago, we shut down schools, shut down churches, shut down restaurants, shut down sporting events, shut down concerts. Any place there was a crowd was suddenly off limits because of COVID. But we need to understand that Jesus drew crowds, he drew people to him because he taught truth, because he showed compassion, and because he offered hope, the hope of forgiveness of sins, the hope of eternal life. And so this is why people came to Jesus. And I just want to remind you, this is what we're trying to do at Calvary. We want to teach truth because we believe the Bible is the inerrant, inspired word of God that tells us what to believe and how to live. And that's why we give Bibles away. That's why we want you to read the Bible, because we want you to know the truth of God, because we want to teach truth. We think people are drawn to truth because truth will set you free. And then, of course, we want to show compassion. That's why we're generous here at Calvary. That's why we bless people all the time. This past year, we gave over $170,000 to the people of Lake Havasu City and Parker, trying to make these communities better, trying to help families, trying to feed people, all of that, because we want to show compassion. And of course, we're doing Serve Our Schools. Did I mention that already? We're doing that because we want to show compassion to our community. Besides, it's our community, they're our schools, we want to make them better because we live here. But we also want to bless the people in Jesus' name. And then we're trying to offer hope, because everyone needs forgiveness of sins. And if you don't have forgiveness, you don't have hope. Everybody wants to go to heaven, and Jesus is the only way to get there. So we want to tell them the truth about Jesus. We want to offer that hope that death is not the end, that you don't have to fear it, because Jesus has provided eternal life. So that's what we're doing here at Calvary, and honestly, that's why we believe people show up. That's why Calvary's been growing as a ministry for almost three decades. And so let me ask you this question. What about you? Are you speaking truth? You really can't unless you know Scripture, unless you read the Bible, unless you learn the Bible, unless you memorize the Bible, unless it's in you. And so I hope and pray you're hiding God's word in your heart that you might not sin against God. So are you speaking truth? Are you showing compassion? Now, everybody thinks they're showing compassion, but are you actually showing kindness to people that don't deserve your kindness? Are you blessing the servers and the clerks and the staff in places that you go? Are you being generous? Are you helping people? Are you serving in some capacity? Now, maybe you can't show up Saturday for Serve Our Schools, but what are you doing to make a difference for the kingdom? And then are you offering hope? Do your words bless people and point them to Jesus? Do your words demonstrate grace and mercy that is available from God? Do your words convey that promise of eternal life that you know you have because of Jesus? You see, if you do those things, if you offer hope, if you show compassion, if you speak truth, then you're going to have influence with people. Crowds may not flock to you, but you're going to have influence with people. And you're going to be able to lead them to a life-changing relationship with Jesus, which is what we're all about. I hope you have a blessed day, Calvary, and I pray that God is filling you with hope and truth and compassion. God bless.